All right, what's up everybody and welcome to my first ever vlog. So yeah, that's really nice. This is my first time vlogging. Yeah. So for this episode, we are going to talk about artworks that is found here in my hometown, which is the biggest city in Metro Manila, which is Quezon City, QC. All right, we're going to talk about the artists itself, the symbol of the art, and my thoughts about the artwork. So what are we waiting for? I think we should just start. All right, where's the transition? All right, let's go. All right, coming in at the first spot, this is a mural found in EDSA, which is, I think, all of you or most of you probably seen this one. This is an art or a mural called Lakbay para sa Kapayapaan sa EDSA. The 3.7 kilometer mural art is a project of Armed Forces of the Philippines along with approximately 3,000 volunteers to build this art. Unfortunately, I can't give you the whole mural itself since it's pretty long. That is 3.7 kilometers. This art is one of the longest mural art in the world, and it wraps around the perimeter fence of Armed Forces of the Philippines headquarters on Bonifacio Avenue, Epifanio de los Santos Avenue, and White Plains Avenue in Quezon City. This art symbolizes peace, order, responsibility, and most importantly, the unities of the Filipinos. And for me, I also have the same thoughts since 3,000 Filipinos joined together to create such an astonishing art. Well, that's unity for you. For the second art, it is a painting back in 1937, which was made by the National Artist for Visual Arts, Mr. Fernando Amorsolo. And the name of this painting is Dalagang Bukid. In this painting, it is a girl wearing blouses and skirt, or also known in the Philippines as Barot Saya. It is also a visual representation on how Filipinos lived before colonization of the Americans. For me, when I look at the painting, when I see the Filipina girl's smile, I feel like I was pushed back in 1937. It feels like I'm in a grassy fields, roaming around with my significant other. As of now, this painting is located at Ateneo Art Gallery in Katipunan, QC. Alright, we were done with one last artwork, and for this one, it is a sculpture. And I think this is the most famous sculpture that you can ever find here in my hometown, which is QC. And can you guess what it is? 3, 2, 1. Right, it is located in UP Diliman, which is the most famous oblation. This sculpture was made by the national artist Guillermo Tolentino back in 1939 in UP Manila. But later on in 1949, it was moved in UP Diliman. For the words of Mr. Guillermo Tolentino, the oblation interprets the second stanza of Mi Ultimo Adios by Jose Rizal. Here is the second stanza translated by Nick Joaquin. Kindly pause the video if you want to read it. Quick fact, did you know that the first original plan for the oblation itself is that the man is completely naked? Former UP President George Pacobo says that it needs to be modified since morality is prevailing that time. So they modified it and put a leaf. So fun fact again, you know, the leaf used in the sculpture itself is katakataka or the wonder leaf. I think that's just about it. I hope all of you guys learned something about the artworks that I presented right now in this video. So I think that's just about it. Goodbye, see you again in my next vlog. Am I going to vlog again? Alright, let's go, bye!